Hello. Today I'd like to show you how a normal user can log into the web UI of PrivacyID, enroll a token, and how he logs in with this OTP token to the web UI. But first, we need to log in as normal administrator to PrivacyID to make it visible for you what passwords I'm typing. I'm using the keymon tool here in the upper right corner. So let's log in as administrator. Do you remember being logged out quite quickly? The default logout time is set to 30 seconds. In PrivacyID 2.2, you can configure the default logout time using a policy. I think I already did it. I defined a policy with logout time to be 60 seconds. So now let's take a look at the users. I already set up a user resolver to my local Open LDAP server. This resolver finds 13 users. To make these users available, I need to put the resolver into a realm. So I define a new realm and I choose only this resolver in the realm. Now I will be able to see the new users in the realm LDAP. Down here is the user PI tester. I will use this account to log in to the web UI. Okay, now as the administrator logged out, another user can log in, and the normal user just logs into the very same UI as the administrator did. The user has to specify, if he's not in the default realm, in which realm he's located. The user PI tester is located in the realm LDAP. Now the user is logging in with his normal LDAP password, which is test 123 exclamation mark. So go login. As you can see, it worked well. The user logged into the UI, but he only gets a limited view on the web UI. He can see his token, he has no token, and he can see his audit log. So the user should enroll a new token. Let's enroll just an event-based HOTP token. I will use my Google Authenticator, or you can use a free OTP, and you set a password, a PIN. I use HOTP to be the OTP PIN. I let the server generate the OTP key, which gives me a QR code I can scan. So the user clicks enroll, and now he can scan the QR code. If you like to, you can also scan the QR code to verify the OTP value when logging in with the OTP value. I also go to the token again, and I can test the token with HOTP and the one-time password 744. Test successful. So now the user has enrolled a token on his own and he can log out again. Now the administrator needs to reconfigure a policy so that the user needs to log in with the OTP. So we again go to the policies. We use this policy in the scope web UI. And here we have an action login mode. We choose login mode to be PrivacyID. The default is user store, But if we choose privacy ID, this means that the user who is logging into the web UI will be authenticated against privacy ID. Of course, you can define the policy depending on the client or the realm, which means you can have different login modes depending on if the user authenticates from a local network or, for example, from the firewall. The administrator logs out again. And now you will see that the PI tester LDAP user is not able to log in with his old password, which is test3. But he needs to authenticate with his one-time password, which is HOTP. And the next OTP value, which is 293511, login. And here we go. You see the user authenticated with his OTP token, and he can see his OTP token. And in the audit log, he will only be able to see events corresponding to his user. Okay, that's it. In the next video, I will show you how you can log in with the OTP as administrator. So stay tuned and thank you for watching.